usable for your own self, particularly for those who have implemented smart watering systems. You can deploy this in your building, in your societies, and whatever you set out to do, why not actually make it count, make it apply at least to your home at first, and maybe then to a little bit wider audience, to your building, or for people who are doing some smart transportation. You know, can you do it at least, deploy certain things on your car? Try to get to that next stage. I'm sure that will be a completely different look, right? I'm sure you'll choose different sensors from the ones that you chose right now, because this was just prototyping. There, what you want to do is less invasive stuff, something which can be deployed easily, right? You'll be looking at things like, okay, fine, this made sense when I was doing just one unit. If I have to do 10 units or 15 units or 100 units, then what do I change? So go and do that step, because everyone does this. Everyone does the basic prototyping, but that's where things stop. But I think the interesting part comes in, that interesting constraints start cropping up as you start trying to deploy this in real life, not to a really thousands and thousands of audience, but just one person or just one family or a group of families in a building. So I would highly recommend that all of you go and do that step, right? In beyond that, what as Meetup Group, what we decided was that we would like to hear your feedback. And in fact, what we'll do is that we'll host a special meetup 1.5 months from now, which should give you some enough time to, you know, work out some mechanics for your solution. So we will have a meetup session at the end of August where, you know, folks from you can come and say, this is the difference, what I did in a prototype, and this is what I learned while I tried to apply this to, you know, something which is a real life use case, or maybe a group of, and we would like to hear that. So I highly encourage you to do that. Send us email saying, I'm interested to talk about it. You could just be talking for 5 minutes, that's fine. But whatever you're learning is there, it is important for the others to understand as well, right? So, would you be doing it?
Yes.
All right, excellent. So that's the second part. And then a kind of related part is that you guys have been, all of you have been very closely associated with this meetup group throughout these 40 hours of time. And I encourage all of you to, as you start understanding newer technologies, learning newer technologies, we would love to have you be presenters in the meetup group, be active members of the community, contribute into what should the next sessions be, where who can talk about things, and you know, if you can talk about certain technologies, then that would be welcome too. All right, so that finishes my talk about the meetup group. Now a word of thanks is in order for all those people who made this happen. As I said, the first and foremost is all you guys who participated for this 40 hours, and you know, a big thumbs up for all of you. Thanks for coming by and helping us. Secondly, a great, great contribution from ThoughtWorks for making all of this space available, for providing us food. Make a special thanks to the facilities and security staff who has also been here through this entire time supporting us. So I think we should have a huge round of applause for our next thanks are in order for Altizone and their team. Rajesh, Atul, who have been here throughout both these days as well, and then who are also participated in the judging panel as well as sponsoring the prizes for this event. So thanks to Altizone. Thanks to Marvel for providing a bunch of mentors for the boot camp as well as on-site. So thanks to Kaustubh, Nikita, Rishikesh, Piyush, Amit, Manas, Ame. Everyone, thanks for being here throughout the bootcamp as well as the hackathon. Thanks to MakerWill, who's been so particularly Anuj and Rohit. I'm sure all of you enjoyed their sessions, very entertaining, and the hardware, knit hardware that they have been working on. So thanks for being here. Thanks to Analog Devices. So Mohit Arora, we had a wonderful session from him, and then the judging committee as well. Thanks to all our judging team members who've been here. Thanks to YSIP Labs from Canada, who's done the sessions in the bootup camp as well as the hackathon. And then thanks to the amazing organizer team, Milind, Saket, Mahesh, Amit, Subhash, and all of you guys. Thanks for making this happen. And let's have a huge round of applause for both. And let me also apologize because I'm sure I've forgotten someone. So no offense, no harm. It's just, you know, it's been very tiring. Thanks all.